So what's your good name?
So Brijesh Jyoti upadhyay.
Okay, Upadhyay is your surname.
Yes, sir.
And the name is
Brijesh.
Brijesh.
Yes,
and this Jyoti is the middle name.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the meaning of the term Brijesh?
So Brijesh is a term which combines bridge plus Ish. Lord Krishna was Isha Bridge, so that refers to Lord Krishna, sir. So Brij region.
Brij is the region.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Lord Krishna.
Yes, sir.
Any three qualities of Lord Krishna?
Yes, sir.
Any three lessons you can gain from Lord Krishna?
Sir, Lord Krishna was very compassionate. Means they used to help their fellow friends with. Sir, and secondly, sir, Lord Krishna was very focused on his dharma, the duty. The Bhagavad Gita, which originated from the discourse between Lord Krishna and Arjuna, was based on his commitment towards duty, sir. Yes, sir. And sir, other thing is that, sir, he always supported one party which was right, sir.
Right.
So, in any case, he always supported right.
Right. All these qualities will help you also.
Yes, definitely, sir.
Okay, so tell me something about the Basti district.
Yes, sir. Basti district is in the northeast region of Uttar Pradesh. It is one of the typical district of our eastern Uttar Pradesh, sir.
Yes.
It is very rich in fertile land, sir. Mm-hmm. It is famous for its sugarcane production. Mm-hmm. And sir, it is primarily based on agriculture, sir. Agriculturally dominant population is there, sir. But sir, some negative aspect is that, sir, it is backward as compared to other districts of India, sir.
Okay.
It is improving since last few years, sir. And nowadays, there is lot of rural to urban migration in the city to have better education and other facilities.
Have you asked to become the collector of DM? What will be your top priorities?
Sir,
DM of Basti district.
Yes, sir. Sir, in my district, there are few main issues, sir. First is, sir, government deficit. Like, government services are not getting into the citizens' lives, sir, effectively, sir.
Effective.
So, there is problem of corruption and accountability problem. So, I will first focus on that, sir. Because government gives us so much opportunity to improve lives of citizens. If there is leakage and corruption, they don't exist there. Second is, sir, the skill level of the citizens is not very good, sir. And so I will focus on skilling them, sir, so that their migration from farming to non-farming sector happens. And sir, I will also take steps to incentivize investment by private industries, sir, because there is lack of economic development.
Now my point is, if you ask to become the DM of the Basti district, now what specialized knowledge of computer engineering you will apply for the betterment of this? Now it is no question is, whatever you have studied in computer, how need that will apply?
Sir, as I have studied computer science and also worked as a software engineer, I have very much idea about how to convert real life problems and into computer applications, sir. And I will try to benefit from the e-governance model of the government and the Digital India program. And I will try to see what actual problem I can solve of the citizens using this Digital India program. Like, sir, I will try to build some apps or some portal where citizens can put their feedbacks and citizens can have better government information, sir, and also they can have better knowledge about the scheme.
Yeah.
So I will try to automate, sir, some provisions of.
Now again, even a more specific question: how you will apply the knowledge of cloud computing in the betterment of the your district?
Sir, the thing is that cloud computing gives us a platform where high level of data processing, data storage, and their retrieval. Retrieve of data, retrieval of data can happen. In the Basti district, sir, there is lack of infrastructure of this storage system. What I will do, sir, that to manage to have a faster application delivery, faster management of government to citizen interaction. I will use cloud computing all the service delivery provisions, sir, so that citizens can have their mobile phone in their hand and can connect to that cloud computing and can access government services and information, sir.
Now again, another specific question related with your biodata and the administration. How you apply your knowledge about, have you knowledge about the blockchain that has been talked about?
Yes, sir.
So how specifically you will apply your knowledge of blockchain in the betterment industry if you are asked to become the DA?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not very much aware of how to use in this context. But sir, blockchain gives us a system where we can have distributed ledger management system, sir. So our financial transaction and financial management can be done through blockchain technology. Sir, we get various funds in a district for betterment of citizens, like sir, Manrega funds and other subsidies, other pensions, sir. So these facilities can be applied over blockchain technology so that it is very safe. There is no leakage, there is no corruption and total transparency.
So in, okay, this is the financial. So in non-financial, how you apply blockchain?
Sir, I have also read that Government of India is also planning. So the thing is that, sir, distribution of like LPG gases, distribution of certificates, distribution of other services, These can be applied over blockchain so that there is transparency and there is safety, sir.
Safety,
there is
trust. Accountability.
Yes, sir. Accountability.
Better than control.
Yes, sir.
Right. So after 2014, what kind of how you are you able to pass your time? Like,
I resigned my job for full-time preparation of civil services, and after that, sir, I have been giving attempts of civil services examination, and I have seen ups and tides in this journey, and so, sir, I have been totally focused on this preparation, sir, to get this civil service.
Why you opted for geography as an option?
Sir, when I saw the syllabus of geography, the physical geography part interested me, sir, because I have been a software engineer and also from science background. So the concept of climatology, oceanography, geomorphology, I feel quite related. I thought that it is scientific, and so I will be quite familiar with the concept and will get easier.
The temperature in Amritsar is sometimes below 0 degrees, but there is no snowfall, whereas the temperature in Shimla will be around 0, even then there will be snowfall.
Yes.
What kind of reason?
Sir, there are a few reasons, sir. First is that, sir, the formation of snow, sir, the precipitation, whether it is in form of rain or snow, depends upon the upper troposphere clouds, sir. If the raindrops get freeze over on the top,
yes.
So Shimla is at high altitude, sir. So their upper troposphere has very frigid conditions, sir.
Why there is a biggest run in runoff match? India's biggest run is it? Why is it the biggest run?
Sir, I'm not very sure on this, but I think, sir, there was confluence of ocean in geological history, sir, and the ocean waters included over the area, sir, and there we have the salt.
The very low lying area, yes, at the very, very close to the main sea level. Previously, we saw this continental shelf was a part of the ocean.
Yes, sir, yes.
So there is a recent surgical strike by India at Balakot and other places. So why that strike was done in Balakot only?
Sir,
why he picked the Balakot?
Sir,
why they picked the Muzaffarabad?
Sir, as per the government, we took a non-military preemptive strike over Balakot because we had intelligence report that the JEM is based there and they are planning to have some further terrorist attack over India, sir. So we chose the place as a that because that is hub of terrorist training, sir.
So, what kind of planes we have preferred for that surgical strike attack?
Sir, it was Mirage 2006.
Why did you pick the Mirage 2000? I had a other place. Because after the Mirage, we have the Sukhoi.
Yes,
Mirage is a little older kind of plane, 60, 70, 1780s kind of plane. After that, in 90s, we have the Sukhoi.
Yes,
the last 40, 40 years, we don't have a plane after Sukhoi.
Yes,
why you pick the Mirage?
I'm not sure.
So Mirage has a more better speed than the Sukhoi and others. Even it has more speed than the F-16 Pakistan.
Okay, sir.
It has a speed of Mach 2.2, around 2,500 km/h.
Yes, sir.
It's lighter in weight, its maneuvering is easy.
Mm-hmm.
And in Mirage we have the magnetic missile, crystal magnetic missile system, which is in a very few countries in the world. So it's quite advanced.
Okay, sir.
These are the some reasons for people in Mirage.
Thank you, sir.
So, when our planes into the fighter planes intruded, why Pakistan could not, their radar could not catch our planes?
Sir, there was a report that our planes flew very lower and it prevented capturing by radar due to its low altitude, sir. And also that, sir, it was very fast operation, sir. It lasted for 1 to 2 minutes after entering the LOC, sir.
So no, it's not for 1 to 2. It was around 5 to 7 minutes on each side, Valakor.
Mm-hmm.
Around 5 to 7 minutes on three sides.
I think our fighter planes also disguised by attacking some other facilities at the south, sir.
Before the attack, we had the surveillance plane. They jammed there.
Okay.
Radar position. So recently, one missile has been found in India which belongs to the Pakistan.
Yes, sir.
What is named that missile and what is the controversy related to that?
Sir, it is F-16 missile which was used by Pakistan as an offensive operation over India's military installations. And sir, it is provided to Pakistan by USA to have defense capability to target other terrorist attacks, sir. But sir, they use this as an offensive purpose, sir. So that's why, and they are not accepting that they have used it due to US sanctions fear, sir.
What is the name of the missile? And long missile.
Yes, sir.
Advanced, medium range.
Yes, sir.
So, in OIC meeting recently, what is the stand of India?
Sir, as per our external affairs minister, Sri Sushma Swaraj, Srimati Sushma Swaraj, she said that terrorism does not belong to a religion. Terrorism is a problem which is being faced by every type of country, every type of religion. So we should fight together against the terrorism. And she also strictly said that the state supporting terrorism must be punished, must be dealt with strictly, sir.
Yes. So recently one squadron leader is in roots. What is his name and what is his achievement?
Sir, the squadron leader name is Wing Commander Abhinandan Vartham. And sir, his achievement is that he prevented the F-16's attack over India and he also shot down that plane which is now a matter of controversy as being used by Pakistan. So his achievement is that, sir, he helped India, he prevented the offensive attack.
So that MiG-21 and F versus F-16, what is the, is there a gap in the generation or the same one?
Sir, I think this was MiG-21 Bison, which is a bit upgraded. So the yes, sir, it is still gap is in there, but sir, we have upgraded planes, so that helped us, sir.
To which generation MiG belongs, and to what generation F-16 Pakistan is even that now?
Sir, I'm not sure, but MiG belongs to third generation, I think, and F-16 belongs to fourth generation.
Correct, sir. But you know, whenever some military operations are there between India and US, so making wrong is a competitive plane against the F-16.
Yes,
F-16 is a basically American plane made by the Lockheed Martin company.
Yes,
so it's a good plane, even though the one generation behind, but it's a good plane.
Yes,
okay. So why Pakistan has to leave the our squadron leader?
Yes.
What kind of pressures will be there? What protocols could be there?
Sir, I think there are various reasons, sir. The most important reason is the Geneva Convention on Treatment of Prisoners of War, sir.
Yes.
So, because he was prisoners of war, our squadron leader was down due to and war situation, sir. So Pakistan has had to release that. Secondly, sir, there was very high international pressure due to India's prominent standing that Pakistan has to release that, sir. And secondly, sir, Pakistan was afraid of our escalation. If it hasn't released it, India would have really have taken
very seriously. Recently, there are talks between North Korea and US.
Yes.
Can you elaborate about that?
Yes, sir. US and other prominent countries are fearing that the weapon which North Korea has, the nuclear weapon and nuclear facility, that affects the security of East Asian region, sir. The security of Japan and South Korea, which are kind of ally of USA. And USA has also put sanction on North Korea due to this, sir. So, the situation is that, sir, North Korea wants its sanctions removed, USA wants its nuclear facility destroyed.
Yeah.
So, these two leaders are meeting to have a negotiation over these.
So, what was the outcome?
Sir, sadly, this time the meeting didn't come to a conclusion because North Korea wanted to have full waiver of the sanctions, but it was saying only one nuclear facility would be closed, sir. So, USA was not trying to.
Recently, there are US-Taliban talks.
Yes.
What is the stand of India?
Sir, India's stand was and still is that any negotiation with Taliban, any negotiation with Afghan has to be Afghan-owned, Afghan-led and Afghan process, sir. So, India's stand is that, sir, US should also talk to the Afghan government. But, sir, seeing the de facto situation, I think India should now change it a bit because, sir, it is true that in reality when the US to withdraw from there, Taliban will gain power, sir. So that's why India also sent two non-official observations.
What is the interest of Russia and United States in Venezuela?
Sir, US interest is that Venezuela's oil economy was totally controlled by US till few years back, sir, till 1990s, and it still has very high stake in its oil resources, sir. So USA want to have a president which is supportive of US, sir, which is ally of US, because sir, US has to buy oil from there, sir. And sir, Russia's interest is that, sir, one is that it kind of doesn't want US to have still hegemony over other states, sir. Second is, it has been a supporter of Venezuela's regime which was socialist in nature, sir. That's why the country like Russia and China are still supporting.
What is the name of the president who is having a socialist regime?
Sir, currently the President Maduro and his predecessor, the Hugo Chavez, sir, they are socialist.
So, if there is a recent effort by the P3 nations against Masood Azhar, so number one, what are the P3 nations, and number two, what was their proposal?
Sir, given India's continuous demand that this terrorist organization and its terror leader, the organization is Jaish-e-Mohammed and its leader Masood Azhar, has to put under the sanction of UN 21267 sanction list, sir. So the P3 nations are USA, Britain and the France. These are permanent nations, permanent members of Security Council, sir. So they have resolved to put that.
So what will be the implications if Masood Azhar is declared an international terrorist? What will be the implications?
Sir, it will have some significant effect, sir. First is that, sir, his funding and its organization would be banned from receiving foreign funds, from even from financial transactions, sir. He will be banned from flying over countries who are supporting this resolution, sir. And it will cripple the organization, sir, because UNSC, United Nations Security Council, is the most important security organization at the international level, sir. If it sanctions someone as a terrorist, then I think no country would even try to support it, and it even cut funding to Pakistan, sir, because multilateral institution would not try to fund it.
So after this, would Masood Azhar will be detained by the Pakistani government?
Sir, I think there will be pressure on it, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. There will be pressure on it to detain, sir. But
it's not a necessity.
Yes, sir.
He will be allowed to move freely.
Yes, sir.
He can operate with another organizations with a different name of the different organization. He can have a different bank accounts.
Yes, I think
this
so.
Is more a token kind of.
Yes, sir. But law of the land of.
Yeah, it's a kind of moral kind.
Yes.
If it happens. So how many times Pakistan has used, how many times China has used its veto power in, for not declaring Masood Azhar as a terrorist?
Sir, I think it has happened 3 times, sir. It is the 4th time when India is going to put it again, sir. But 3 times China has put technical hold over this, sir.
4 times already. Have you heard about the masala notes? What are the masala notes?
Yes, sir. As the name suggests, masala bonds, sir. These are bonds which currency has to be Indian rupee, sir. They are not purchased from dollar, sir. So it gives very, very important incentive to Indian investors because, sir.
Investors abroad or?
Sir, abroad, sir. Because sir, exchange rate risk would be borne by them, sir. We would be free from the bonds exchange rate risk, sir. And
so how the masala bond affects the Indian rupee?
I think, sir, it protects our depreciation.
Yeah, protects the depreciation. Right. Recently, Article 35A is in news. What is that?
Sir, original Article 35A belongs to our Constitution Article 317. According to that, sir, there was a presidential order in 1954 which put an other article, Article 35A, which gives some special rights, special fundamental rights to the residents of Jammu and Kashmir, like no outsider can buy property there and buy land there, sir. So it is was a special gesture by the Indian government to protect their autonomy. In that sufficient, sir. It was a temporary provision.
What is the provision in 35?
Sir, I am only aware of the residency.
The government of the legislature of J&K can make law for the protection of the residents.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There is a country which is making a space force. Can you elaborate on that? The space force, the army for the space.
Sorry, sir, I am not very sure. I think China is doing this.
It is US. Is looking at space force.
Sorry, sir, I don't think
so. India has made a new LC light combat aircraft. Can you throw light on that?
Sir, I think you are referring to the Tejas aircraft being made by HAL, sir. And it is your first indigenous high quality aircraft, sir. And it will help in India's Make in India policy, its defense sector, and also, sir, export of our weapons to others.
How many years India took to complete it?
Yes, sir.
More than 3 decades. 35 to 36 years later. So to which generation does it belong?
And really sorry.
4 generations. US is having which generation like?
Yeah, I think upward of 5th generation.
There is no 6th generation. How the generations are there? The 6th generation will be totally using artificial intelligence.
Oh, okay, sir.
So, tell me something about the national emergency in the US. Why there is a national emergency in the US?
Sir,
which is declared on 15th of February 2020.
Sir, I think US National Presidency Declaration by US President was a kind of leverage tool to have his bill passed by the Congress, sir, because sir, US President wanted to have funds for having a wall, steel wall between border of Mexico and USA to prevent illegal immigration, sir. And so this was a tool kind of, sir. used by teams.
What is the cost of that wall? US Mexico.
Yes, sir. I think US President is offering, is saying, asking about $5 to $6 billion, sir, for the wall build. But the Congress is only saying it will give around $1.5 billion, sir.
That's so when he is majority, why he is not able to pass?
Sir, because in that presidential system, sir, it is the Congress which is the sole right on the money matters, sir. And President of United States has not much authority on money matters, sir.
So in which house he has the majority?
Sir, in Senate, sir. In Senate, Republican Party has the majority, sir.
In US, which house is more powerful? Representative or Senate?
Sir, Senate, sir.
Senate is upper house or lower house?
Sir, upper house.
So, what is the policy of United States under Mr. Trump related with the Syria?
Sir, Mr. Trump's main manifesto was he has to withdraw from international conflict zone, sir. He has said that he will only concern with America's own policy, sir. Make America great again, sir. So his policy is the withdrawal of his troops. He is now withdrawing from the conflict zone, sir.
And what is the policy of Russia related with Syria?
Sir, Russia is a heavy supporter of the current regime, Assad regime, sir. And Russia has very heavy interest there, sir, due to the access of Russia, Iran and Syria, sir. These three are with the current regime, and Russia wants to stay there as a hold over the geopolitics of the West Asian region, sir.
Syria has given an important port to Russia. Can you give the name of that port?
I'm not aware of the exact name.
That is the main interest of Russia.
Yes, sir.
That is the port of Tartu. It has been given by the Assad regime to Russia. And ideologically also Assad belongs to the Ba'ath party, which is basically a socialist, communist kind of party. In the constitution of Thailand, some changes are made which has quite worried to the world community. What are those changes in the constitution of Thailand?
I have very little idea about it, sir.
No, their military, actually their military is commanding these things, and they have made their upper house totally appointed by the military. So it won't be elected, sir. This is how the growing military
control, sir.
Okay. What is currently the situation of what is currently the how the relations are there between the Qatar and Saudi Arabia?
Sir, relation between Qatar and Saudi Arabia has declined in last 1-2 years, sir. Due to, sir, Qatar regime is basically supportive of countries like Iran and Russia, and sir, it also supports Muslim Brotherhood type situation, sir. Because, sir, Saudi Arabia want to protect its rule over Saudi Arabia, and it doesn't want any disruption, sir. The disruption like Arab Spring or other revolution, sir. That's why Saudi Arabia has broken up its relation with Qatar, sir.
So Saudi Arabia is the leader of which Muslim world? Shia or Sunni?
Sir, it is leader of Sunni, sir. I think Qatar is...
Yeah, Qatar?
Sir, I'm not sure, but I think it is Shia.
So what is the stand of Saudi Arabia related to Islamic State?
Sir, Saudi Arabia is against of Islamic State, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And it also supported US over its war over the ISIS region, sir.
It has initially brought a report that it has given huge fund to Islamic State. Saudi Arabia has given the huge funding to the Islamic State.
I'm really sorry, sir. I'm not aware of the situation.
The Islamic State is basically a Sunni organization.
Okay, sir.
And Saudi Arabia is a leader. So initially it funded Islamic State. Mm-hmm. When Islamic State went out of the hand, then it stopped.
So you mean, sir, it was inclined towards
the Islamic State? Yeah, initially.
800 days. Sir, just one query, sir. Yeah. But sir, US wanted to abolish Islamic State and US is close partner of Saudi Arabia in West Asian region, sir. So how this channel?
Because of the leadership, it wants to protect the leadership. Even the US indirectly helped the Islamic State, what you say?
Seriously, sir?
Yeah. When US withdrew, not the current regime, previously, when US withdrew from Iraq,
yes,
it did not take some of its weapons deliberately. And they were initially occupied by the Islamic State. Why?
The reasons of the Saudi Arabia's pressure.
No. Because actually, US does not want the Assad regime.
Okay.
The point is, the US neither wants, that time US main enemy in Syria was the Assad regime. It's basically the communist government.
So he wanted to use
Islamic State.
Yes.
Then it stopped funding even Islamic State. So the stand of US is neither it wants the Assad government nor it wants the Islamic State.
Okay,
the things are changing from time.
Yes,
and the Saudi Arabia, initially it funded, being a leader of the Sunni, it funded Islamic State.
Yes,
there will be an Islamic regime.
Yes,
like in Iraq, there was a rule of, you know, in the Saddam Hussein. So that was okay, but after that there was a vacuum. So they wanted to revive the Sunni regime. Initially, Saudi Arabia funded Islamic
State.
Then,
sir, I have two queries, sir. Yeah. In open, does Saudi Arabia still says that it supported?
No, not at all. Not at all. Nobody says. Nobody says. Saudi Arabia does not say.
Second query is a bit long, sir. How will the withdrawal of US from Syria will affect the situation, sir?
Russia can handle the things. Right from the time when Trump took over the presidentship, he clearly said, let Russia bash the Islamic State. And Russia really bashed the Islamic State.
So Islamic State is now totally...
But all, matlab, you can say it has lost most of its.
Sir, I still wonder, sir.
Yeah.
In Syria, there are two stakeholders I know. One is Assad regime, one is rebel, sir. And one is
there are no
Kurds.
Kurds are there.
So can you give me one line?
No, Kurds are not simply a stakeholder in Turkey. Kurds are the stakeholder in number of areas.
Yes, sir. So the continuous border between because Syria and Turkey.
All area, so they are the stakeholders in north of
Iraq.
They are in Syria. And
south of Turkey.
I think north of Turkey. So they are the stakeholders in number of countries.
So US withdrawal would boost up them or not?
The US withdraw from where?
Syria, sir.
US withdraw from Syria would boost up the Kurds. I can't say straight away without studying deeply. In general, okay. We can say if US is withdrawn, so there may be little vacuum. That vacuum may be occupied by the Kurds.
Okay.
According to their space.
That's why I think Turkey was
general,
worried.
Turkey.
Turkey is against Kurds.
Because the largest Kurd area is in Turkey actually. So Turkey is more worried. Turkey is more worried because the largest Kurd area is in Turkey.
And they want autonomy.
Yeah, and you know, everywhere they want autonomy. In Iraq also, they have the autonomous province everywhere. Initially they want autonomy and then they want the independence. Turkey is the most worried from the Kurds, being the largest area, and their Kurds are the strongest. But US withdraw karega, so in general vacuum to hoga, and that vacuum can be filled by even the Kurds. Depending on area.
Yes, sir.
They are occupying the huge area. So this is it. Take it up. Recently, there is a 103rd constitutional amendment, that is the latest constitutional amendment. Can you elaborate that?
Sir, this 103rd constitutional amendment has amended Article 16(5) and 15(5), sir. It gives reservation to economically weaker sections who still didn't have any kind of reservation, sir. So, sir, the principle behind this amendment is that Article 46 of the Constitution of DPSP says that the state has to take action to protect weaker sections of the society. So the government has took this step, sir. And we have now 10% reservation in the education and employment.
Yeah. What is the limit of the income?
Sir, it has 8 lakh per annum family income limit, sir. And also some other provisions to make economic backwards.
So, do you think it is against the guidelines of the Supreme Court which says reservation cannot be more than 50%?
Sir, since it is constitutional amendment, although yes sir, I agree that it is amazing, but sir, now the whole parliament has amended the constitution sir, so I think it is still constitutionally valid until unless Supreme Court finds it violative of basic.
Has Supreme Court started studying it?
Sir, I think PIL has been filed and Supreme Court has accepted it.
So do you think in India reservation should be increased or they should be now gradually reduced?
Sir, in my personal opinion, the reservation policy hasn't worked as expected, sir. And there need to be reform in the policy, sir. But sir, I don't think the existing 50% reservation should be reduced. Because sir, we still see many reports that there is still disproportionate representation of backward communities in employment and education, sir. So I think this project and technology.
Do you think Article 370 should be abolished?
Sir, given the present situation, I would say no sir, it is not the right time. But sir, our long term vision should be that it must be abolished because it was a temporary provision in the constitution and we have to fully integrate the Jammu and Kashmir state with India sir. But the present situation is very volatile. We need to first bring peace to the region sir, then we can.
Any 3 steps to bring peace in the region?
First is sir, we have to protect our borders from infiltration of militants sir. Second is sir, we need to focus more on the problems of Kashmiri citizens sir, because sir there is some lack of trust between them and Indian state sir, even the state of Jammu and Kashmir sir. We need to build that trust sir. And the third would be sir, we have to revive the economy and we have to take steps so that rest of India get integrated with the Jammu and Kashmir region through tourism, through other economic activities sir, and there should be a better connectivity with the region sir, and safety sir.
What is the RBI scheme related with the prompt corrective action frameworks?
Sir, a few years back RBI was very worried due to the rising share of NPA sir. And when the financial viability of a bank is not sustainable sir, then RBI used to have put them under prompt corrective action. There are few criteria like some ratio of NPA, some ratio of capital adequacy rates sir, and these criteria are used by RBI to put them under NPA.
Yeah. So currently how much money is RBI is planning to employ?
Sir, I think Government of India is planning recently 48 lakh crore. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But sir, it is required, sir, to solve the twin balance sheet problem and to boost the private investment because the banks are not able to loan out and the economic growth has really been restricted due to this.
48,000 crores.
Okay. Sorry, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What are debt recovery techniques?
Sir, debt recovery tribunal are quasi-judicial bodies used to solve the problem of insolvency of private debtors, sir.
And for companies, what is the body?
Sir, it is a national company law tribunal.
In history, any event of your choice?
Sir, the struggle of independence from 1920s to 47, sir.
Any 3 strategies adopted by India in civil disobedience movement? And any 3 strategies, any 3 new strategies in Putin? New strategy in civil disobedience and new strategies in Putin, any 3?
Sir, first strategy which led to civil disobedience movement was the Gandhiji's 11-point demand, and there the demand of salt tax. So the strategy was that Gandhiji focused on something which affects every citizen of India, sir, and which has very high moral value, sir, because salt is a daily consumable option, sir. So first was that use of some very strategic demand, sir. Second is sir, participation of women. and also youths and from and different sections, sir. So civil disobedience movement was first large scale movement where high number of women participated. Third is that, sir, we saw that PGMs in states like Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, they were against the chowkidari tax and they fought against the jamidari cruelty, sir. So I think this led to the Kishan Sabha movement, sir. And means, sir, this civil disobedience movement saw participation of PGM at a large scale, sir, which is not found in NCM, sir, non-cooperation movement and erstwhile movement, sir. So participation of PGM. Sir, in Quit India movement, sir, one of the main feature was that, sir, whole country was involved in both violent, it was a violent movement, sir. There were disruption of British infrastructure, sir, British large infrastructure, sir, participated by youths, by PGMs, sir. So large scale participation against infrastructure of British Raj, sir. Secondly, that, sir, there was absence of Congress leadership, sir. Main leadership was totally absent. Still, the whole country was so enthused. They took action spontaneously, sir. And third it was, sir, we used some really innovative method to have our own propaganda, sir, using undercover radio and other schemes, sir.
So in civil disobedience movement, the first thing is to disobey by breaking the laws, whether it is the soft law,
yes,
whether it is the revenue law,
yes,
whether it is the chowkidari law, yes, whether it is breaking the cutting of something.
Yes.
So and we use the power of the teenage in the movement by forming the Vana Sena and Manjri Sena.
Yes.
That is again a new tool we
have
adopted. And third, another new tool we have adopted by using the early morning time for the nationalism.
Yes.
By the Prabhat Feri nationalism. And after sunset, there were no such street lights. So we have started an innovative thing of magic lantern Satyagraha. Lantern Satyagraha.
It happened in civil disobedience.
Yeah,
movement.
It happened.
So, I think also happened during Swadeshi movement, in Bengal partition. The Prabhat Feris. The Prabhat Feris.
There may be Prabhat Feris, but you know, it's used for a large scale, the Prabhat Feris and the magic lamp.
Yes.
What you said apart from that?
Yes. Thank you, sir.
And in Quit India movement, the great innovations are, for the first time we didn't ask anything from the British. He gave us spoon, Swaraj or Swaraj. We simply said British, you quit India.
Okay, sir.
India for the Indians. Nothing less than the complete
difference.
Yes, sir. We wrote them to move out.
Yes, sir.
And then obviously there was, you know, hinted about that. There was, since it was Gandhiji, all leaders knew they would be behind the bar.
Yes, sir.
So there was no one leader. All Indians were their own leaders.
Yes.
All nationalists were their own leaders.
Yes.
That was very decentralized, the most decentralized world.
Yes,
the Quit India. And one point you have hinted again, there was, since British were very strict because
yes,
of the Second World War,
yes,
so they were the first time great number of underground networks.
Yes.
And no doubt the frequency was also used, the Congress radio was used,
yes,
Usha Mitra and all.
Yes, sir. Usha Mitra.
That was an innovation. Using the frequency and another innovation, the formation of the parallel number.
Yes, sir. I thought this is very important. Yes, sir.
They used to acquire the electorate, they used to put down the Union Jack,
yes,
then put the Telangana, it started.
They totally threw away the British Raj from their district, from their
So, finally, why we should select you for civil services?
Sir, I very strongly believe that I have very good qualities of being a civil servant, sir. I have strong analytical ability, problem solving skill. I am very compassionate to the normal public, sir. I am very dedicated to public service, sir. And sir, I think, sir, I can bring very positive changes in the whole government function in which I will be in the, sir.
Have you shown compassion in your life? Can you prove that?
Sir, I regularly show compassion, sir. Even in my home, sir, when even maid come out, sir, or even small children who roam in my colony, sir, I used to talk to them, I help them in their academics, sir.
Wow. Okay. We have to resolve.
I just gave the one-on-one session with Gaurav sir, and it was really very nice session because the comprehensive coverage of my DAF and other areas were very nice. I got to know many new questions and which might probably be asked in my actual UPSC examination. The best part was that sir was so cordial that he also solved many of my queries during the session too. And one other aspect I would like to highlight that the question of IR was of very high quality, and it really like prepared me for the actual interview in just 30 minutes in the particular IR section. And overall, I really benefited from this session.